26 years old, male, diffuse hair loss. No hope to restore hair. Is hair transplant possible? Is there any possibility to restore my hair? I lost 90% density. Really stressful shedding hair is due to stress, too.
Thank you for your question. You're asking a very straightforward question on whether or not you're a candidate for a hair transplant. You're 26 years old, and you've described having more than 90% hair loss, and that you're also shedding because of stress. Well, I think that you will find my answer interesting, because I think that you're being very honest about the degree of your hair loss, and you are asking a very good question. Instead of asking how many grafts do you need, you're asking, are you a candidate? Now, in looking at someone like yourself, let's just walk through the steps that we use in our practice to assess someone like you, 26-year-old male with this type of hair loss. First, we look at the age of onset. How old were you when you started losing hair? How quickly has this been progressing? Are there male family members who have similar patterns of hair loss? Assuming that what you have, or reasonably concluding that you have male pattern hair loss, what you are experiencing is this progressive miniaturizing of hair. So hair grows in cycles, and at the end of every cycle it sheds, and when the new hairs come in, they come back thinner. So what we would typically do is assess the top of your scalp with a microscope to identify the amount of hairs that are thinning relative to the amount of hairs that are still thick. And although in years past we would have a discussion about considering a hair transplant based on the idea of the limitations of what a hair transplant can do, what I'm going to discuss with you is really an alternative that we have developed in our practice that we call hair regeneration. As I discussed earlier, hair thinning is a progression, and it's a genetically based progression when you talk about male pattern hair loss. Now, when you think about management, there are medical options. One is the drug finasteride. Finasteride is a drug that inhibits an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase that is responsible for the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Hairs that are sensitive to dihydrotestosterone will progressively thin and go away. When someone who has that type of hair loss takes finasteride, it slows down that progression and can allow them to have thicker hair for a longer period of time. The challenge at our current time is that many people are concerned due to medical studies that have shown long-term sexual side effects of taking finasteride. The other drug is minoxidil. Minoxidil is applied topically and appears to keep hair around longer, so that it appears to have more, the scalp has more coverage. It does not reverse hair thinning. What we have developed in our practice is a concept and a treatment called hair regeneration. Serendipitously, a material for wound healing called extracellular matrix that is used to help regenerate tissue placed on skin, it helps regenerate skin by recruiting the adult stem cells to create this type of wound healing mechanism. Placed on muscle, it repairs with muscle. Now, although the literature does not provide enough information to understand all the factors that cause hair thinning, because dihydrotestosterone is not the whole story, many men will take finasteride and still progressively lose hair. What we have seen is when this material is used in a specific way that we've developed in a formulation combined with platelet-rich plasma, it is remarkable. at how effectively it can reverse hair thinning. We have hundreds of patients who come from all over the world, and we have 5 years of data, and every week we see more and more patients for this treatment as we continue to prove its benefit. There are a lot of people who don't believe it, a lot of people who don't believe in it, but we have the patients and the proof to show that as long as you have hair, you have hope. When you look at yourself and you say that you have 90% loss, you would be surprised how microscopically you have a lot more hair than you think. And that means that for someone like you, we don't go to hair transplant first. This is a significant change in the paradigm of how to treat hair loss. And it really goes full on in the face of the standard approach that hair transplant industry has for hair loss. What's that model? That model is do a hair transplant. The patient continues to progressively lose hair. Do another hair transplant. Do another one every few years until you reach the end of the donor area. And unfortunately, there is a mismatch between the amount of hair that you have in the donor and the amount of scalp you need covered. What does that leave people having? Eventually, they can look very pluggy. And pluggy meaning looking like they have an obvious hair transplant. With that understood, we really have created a different solution that is non-surgical, that's an injection that appears to have at a minimum 3 years of benefit and a maximum of 5 years, but our numbers are so much higher within the past 3 years that we can really stand behind the 3 years of improvement with just one injection. And as I said before, as long as you have hair, it's never too late. Every week I continue to be impressed by patients who have come in who are very far along in the level of their advancement of their hair loss. But it appears that the younger you are and the more coarse the hair is, it appears you get remarkably more volume and correction. And I think it has a lot to do with the early intervention. When someone notices hair loss, the earlier they come, the better it is. Now, but that being said, as like I said earlier, it's never too late when there is existing hair. So I've given you something different to think about besides hair transplant, and I think it's an opportunity for you to learn more about this as an opportunity to treat your hair loss. Hair regeneration does work. It is extremely effective. I would actually say that in most patients who have existing hair, it far exceeds the benefits of any hair transplant. And so with that being said, I wish you the best of luck. I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.